I was recently watching the three X-Men movies with a bit of a critical eye this time around. I'm not a huge comic book fan. I do prefer Marvel as opposed to DC, as far as the characters go. I think Batman's probably the best that DC has. Marvel's got a wider array of good stories, Spider-Man and the whole X-Men universe is relevant and more fascinating than most of what DC has to offer. Anyway, I'm not, one of those comic book nuts. I did appreciate the X-Men cartoon when I was younger. It dealt with more issues about prejudice and bigotry, stuff like that. That's why X-Men's relevant. Anyway, as far as the casting of the movies goes, I think they did a really good job on most of the characters. I understand the way that they went with Rogue. For purposes of the story, they kind of combined Rogue's role with Jubilee as far as her relationship with Wolverine, the vehicle that she was in carrying the story through. The relationship between Rogue and Bobby, Iceman, was the relationship between Rogue and Gambit, but Gambit wasn't there, so there's some role replacement there, but the main issue is the same. Rogue's character in the comic and in the cartoon was a not only a, it wasn't a reaction to her life as a in the cartoon she's older than her character incarnation in the movie, but her personality itself was a combination of other well, at least one other person, and a more traumatic upbringing than her character in the movie. She was actually like, it was kind of complicated, but she was raised by Mystique, who was disguising herself as this woman, and eventually she was encouraged to join a version of the Brotherhood of Mutants, of a collection of mutants doing evil for a greater cause. And then later she had a change of heart, and I found out that she was being deceived, and then went to join the X-Men. And her personality itself, her old personality, just Marie, was similar, if not identical, to her role in the movie, in that she's kind of sullen and despondent over the manifestation of her powers, and that she had, I mean, it's profound to not be able to touch another human being. I mean, of course that's going to affect your personality. But then an incident happened in the comics and in the cartoon in which she sucked too much, life juice or whatever it is, out of another a superhero, Marvel Girl, who actually had she was basically a Superman-esque type of hero in she can fly and she was like super strong and all this stuff. I mean, Rogue actually sucked so much stuff out of her that it rendered Marvel Girl into this coma, and she actually has, with the help of Professor X later, of course, managed to contain this, a form of the consciousness of Marvel Girl that's stuck in her brain. Her more outgoing and flirtatious personality that was evident, later in the comics and in the cartoon was a combination of Marvel Girl's personality and the original Marie personality. Now, of course, they're not going to go through that in the movie. So the interactions between Bobby and Rogue in the movie are a lot different than the interactions between Rogue and Gambit in the cartoon and in the comics. And that Rogue's personality in the cartoon and the comics is definitely more flirtatious. And she's like a forbidden fruit type of thing, and that there actually can't be anything besides this sort of intellectual flirtation between the two characters. And every once in a while, Gambit will, sneak a kiss or something, much to Rogue accidentally exploding something by touching it. It's a big mess. So most of the time, it plays out as a sort of intellectual banter, a kind of somewhat serious, but mostly just friendly and lighthearted flirtation. And they had to totally change that in the movie and made her it more of a serious throughout the three films. It's more of a serious problem for Rogue that she doesn't really occasionally deals with in the comic books, but most of the time it's just it's like a superficial window dressing. So as far as the casting for Rogue's character, I thought, you know, considering the changes that they made to make it a little bit more simple and to make sense and more poignant, I think they did a fine job. All the other characters are cast exceptionally well, especially Wolverine, you know, finding the Hugh Jackman in the music theater in Australia, I think was perfect, and that we hadn't, and the American audience hadn't really seen him in anything else before, so there wasn't any association, and for him to actually, you know, he's a bit tall for the role, but that's okay, for him to actually get the personality of the character in such short order, I think is remarkable, and he did a fantastic job. The only bad casting in all the movies, I think, is Halle Berry as Storm, which I'm not the only person to express this view. Storm's a very powerful character. Not only is she tall and a striking image in both the cartoon and the comics, her power is so great, and it's contained within this human body. She's basically a hurricane condensed into a human body, and you can see that just by looking at her. Her presence is supposed to be, you know, have this aura of strength about it, and basically she's walking around like she has a broomstick for a spine. She's always like just walking around with just exuding power wherever she goes. And she is a formidable presence, whether she's actually, you know, flying in the air, you know, summoning lightning strikes, or just standing there not doing anything. You just look at her and you see power. Now, Halle Berry is a fine actress, but as far as portraying this character appropriately, as, you know, as simple and complex a thing as presence is, she does not pull it off. She does not pull it off. Not at all. And though she can, through the dialogue and, you know, subtle movements, she can kind of get some of the more intimate personality traits across. She comes across as being basically a bland character when Storm is not. Though she's almost a flat character, she's definitely, she's almost like, she's like a goddess, basically. The aura that she has about her, I mean, it's like, you know, you walk in a room and everyone turns to look at this, you know, powerful being that just entered the room. Halle Berry does not get that across at all. Whereas, like a Jean Grey or Professor X are deceptively powerful, where they can walk in a room or, you know, roll a wheelchair into a room and, you know, oh yeah, that's just a human being, and they've got this, you know, great power hidden underneath. Storm is apparently powerful. Just a glance and you can tell that this is more than just a human being. This is somebody with a lot of overt and blatant strength. And Halle Berry does not get that across at all. So that's basically my only critique of the X-Men movies. A lot of people, I think, were disappointed with the third X-Men movie because of the high standards raised by the other two. But I think it was it dealt with, well, specifically in Rogue's case, a couple of issues that were serious about, you know, what choices do you make about, are you, you know, do you want to change yourself for you, or do you want to change yourself to fit in? It's an important topic for discussion, and it did it in a not very heady way. But I think the third X-Men movie was definitely a lot more character driven than event driven, and you know, things, Wolverine and Storm's roles were kind of already set, but it definitely went into depth of the younger cast members. So I liked it probably better than most people did. Am I done with my rant? I am done. Please respond if you have anything to add.